What is the craziest encounter of rich kid syndrome that you have experienced? I lived with 5 guys and I was the only one whose parents weren't millionaires. Not clothes at all. They never cleaned. About once a month I would deep clean the house, but 2 days later there was garbage and food on the floor. I found out they all told their parents the poor kid made all the messes when one of their moms came by to scream at me. Please finish your story. Tell me that you proved it was their fault. I almost jumped off the couch at her, but the person to my side held me back. The guy whose mom it was took her outside and said, "Don't come over here to yell at my roommate." I was in disbelief of the whole event. A consulting manager I worked with was literally Stifler. Even looked like him. He was a Harvard grad. Dad was an exec at a huge consulting firm. Smart, but incredibly ditzy and trying really hard to be normal. He walked into work one morning and asked one of his trainees if they got paid this week, because he literally couldn't see the difference in his bank account. Not scathing like most of the ones on here. I grew up attending a private school in a developing country, so a lot of my classmates were in the 1% of the country. Whenever we'd be swimming in the school pool, one friend of ours in particular would always remark that swimming is more fun if the pool has a current or waves. To which I had no idea what he was talking about and generally thought he was just being imaginative. One day he invited me over to his house for swimming and he had a 50-foot indoor pool that generated a current, waves. He wasn't lying. They are a lot more fun. My college roommate's mom gave him f-king $1,400 for the weekend, just randomly. He blew through the whole thing by Saturday, asked his mom for more money and was screaming at her because she promised $1,400 for the weekend and he spent most of what she gave him on Friday, which isn't a part of the weekend. Knew a trust fund girl whose dad gave her the money to start a company. She lost it when she went on vacation for 6 months and forgot she was supposed to pay her employees all the time. She assumed they would not get paid for 6 months and be there when she got back. I quizzed her on this for a few minutes and it was clear she had no idea what a job was. Look up Corona Del Mar High School cheating scandal. Happened at my school. Parents paid around $50,000 apiece to have a tutor bug the school computers and change students' grades. They all lawyered up big time when it came out and all the kids got off free and all made it into their top 3 schools. A friend I met at uni flew from Auckland to London for a week to go shopping. Clothes were cheaper in London. So to him it made sense. His parents were from Singapore and had no idea just how much cheaper cars were in New Zealand. So when he said he needed $70,000 for a Toyota Corolla, they gave him the money and he bought a used BMW M3. When he went home for the summer, he asked if I could mind the car for him. Given his dad had pretty much cut him off at that point, he just said I had to pay for insurance on it and I could treat it like my own. But as a 19-year-old sharing a flat and barely getting by, there was no way I could cover the cost of insurance, let alone petrol. This happened a couple of weeks ago at the Infiniti dealership. I was in the waiting room with a very well-dressed lady for our loaner cars. She left the waiting room to look at her loaner and came back crying. She said she drives a fully loaded QX80 and they gave her a QX60 with nothing in it. I said sorry that happened and asked how long she was going to have the loaner for. She said a couple of hours. I wanted to tell her to suck it up, but instead I sat there quiet thinking how life must be easy for her to cry over a loaner car. A Saudi guy in the UK got in a crash. With light damage to one side of brand new Mercedes. He called for one of his assistants to come get him. Even though the car was fully drivable. My friend rolled up on call with his tow truck and asked the guy where he wanted the Merc towed. The guy gave him the keys and said, "Keep it, I don't want it." Single quote. Damn, I need to befriend some Saudi princes. Girl got a 2-year-old Range Rover for her 17th. Now 20 and still doesn't have her license. Sits unused in their 4-car garage. I used to have a friend who would constantly say, "I love when my dad gives me money." And, if I ask for a certain amount of money, my parents always give me $50 extra. Single quote. Dot. This girl then bought an apartment, boasting about it on Facebook and how proud she was of herself, how at 23 she was able to afford a home at such a young age all on her own. Still makes me want to face plant into a pile of jagged rocks. A girl in my school was surprised by her parents in the school's parking lot with a new BMW. A freaking BMW. Everyone who is out is basically watching this go down and she starts crying. At first we are all thinking it's because she's so happy, but then she runs back into the school. Apparently they were supposed to show up earlier, I'm assuming when there would be more students to witness the surprise. I felt bad for the dad because he looked totally embarrassed and sad about it. You know, in his head he's like, I created this monster. Dad bought his college-aged daughter a house in a very nice neighborhood so that she and her friends could live rent-free while they attended university. He remodeled the entire house. In all, he probably spent close to $2 million. 2 weeks after moving in, they left a candle burning while they went to the store to get snacks for a football game. Came home and the house was on fire. A month later, it was good and new for them to move back in. Not exactly rich kid syndrome. But there was this family that had two children who attended the elementary school that was connected to my middle school. Every day the two parents would leave the house and drive separately to pick up their two kids before returning home. I should mention at this point that they each drove a Lamborghini. One black and one orange. Back to back in the pickup line to get their kids from elementary school. At first I thought they were just being showy. But then I realized that they were two-seaters. So this was really the only way to do it. Modern problem. Modern solution. My personal favorite was in college, kid down the hall from me bought a brand new Fender Stratocaster and played with it for a day and got bored and sold it to me case and all for $20. I still have it and play it 15 years later. It's a great guitar. I knew someone who goes out of the country just to have a haircut. Spoiler. The guy is from the Vatican. I had a scholarship to private school for my secondary education, 11 to 18. We were by no means poor. But compared to the people who were paying full school fees, I was a peasant. The vast majority of the students were wealthy. And about half of them were spoilt little brats. Most of the kids got given cars for their 17th birthday in anticipation of passing their driving tests. One boy in particular in my year had a September birthday. So was one of the first to take his test, and he had a huge house, garden. So he already knew how to drive. You can drive on private land at any age here. On the day he passed his test, he got dropped off back at his school in his shiny new sports car. I don't know what type it was. I'd gaff about cars, but everyone else seemed impressed. He picked up a couple of friends to go for a spin. And before he got approximately 100 meters up the road, he completely wrecked the F-King car. His dad bought him a new one the next day and he complained that it was the wrong color. Had a kid that lived across the hall from me my freshman year of college from Honduras. During one of the icebreakers after freshman move-in, he leaned to me to ask if I knew when the maids came to make his bed clean. I guess his family was very well off in his home country and the entire semester was an eye-opener for him in actually taking care of himself. First day as a librarian in a private school. Help a 7-year-old with the printer. He offers to tip me. I like this one because he's not a snot. He's just trying to be polite. Haha, it's super innocent. Like, kid doesn't know. He's just trying to be like the grown-ups he has grown up around, smiley face. There was this rich kid in our class who was literally disgusted by us buying used stuff, like computer parts, on eBay. Once during conversation I said I bought an eBay memory module for my PC and said to me that I should have a little dignity. And if I buy used stuff I should keep it to myself. This one is kinda mild I guess. But goes to show how clueless wealthy kids can be. Completely unaware of the disparity between them and average income people. Anyways, he picked me up in a new $85,000 sports car one day. The newest Corvette special edition model fresh off the line. I said holy s dude, your car is incredible. He said he wished everyone knew he had to work a full month with his grandfather and earned it himself. I was in a theology class where we were talking about compromises. Teacher, what are some compromises your parents have made? Very rich girl, my mom wanted to go to Hawaii and my dad wanted to go to Mexico, so we went to the Bahamas instead. Going to private school makes life full of these stories. Like earlier this week when I asked why this girl who I sit by was gone. Her friend then told me, she's skipping this week because she wanted to go to the Bruno Mars and Pitbull concert in Hawaii or another one. Last year this girl got too stressed out with school so she went to Lithuania with her dad for a month. I have no idea how she made up all her schoolwork. I watched Rich Kids of Instagram on YouTube and am still recovering. I had two friends in college who were from UAE. They were brothers, and their parents were sending them to school in the US. They were actually pretty cool and down to earth. If not a good bit weird. They knew I didn't have a ton of money and couldn't afford to do the cool stuff they did. So they covered me all the time. Crazy stuff, like renting a private plane to go to a concert, black cars with drivers, expensive dinners in exclusive clubs. On the weird side, they slaughtered a goat in the bathtub to make a traditional Arabian dinner. And they wore far too much Draker. GF family is wealthy. She's working her way to it. But, she was waiting to get a chance for a promotion and the words, "I cannot believe anyone would make somebody work for almost a year to get a promotion," came out of her mouth. And I laughed.